Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. AI image generation has come a long way, and when we talk about Stable Diffusion, it's been 2 complete years. Stable Diffusion first came out in August 2022, and I'm recording this one day after, so it's basically 2 years plus one day. We initially got Stable Diffusion 1.1, and that was by Compbase. Then we got 1.2, 1.3, and 1.4 was the one that users were able to test out. At the time, it was not on par with DALL-E. There was still a lot of things to do with it. But as users, getting their hands on the model was a big thing. But then quickly after, Runway ML release 1.5, and this one was a game changer. Everyone was jumping on Stable Diffusion. We were having web UIs. Even I made a video on how to make your own Gradio application for Stable Diffusion. Everyone was talking about it. Not only that, but the fact that it was easy to train and fine-tune gave rise to community models. We also got websites like Civit.ai, which was hosting those models. Now from there, we got models, we got LoRAs, multiple checkpoints, and so on. Now after that, Stability.ai came with Stable Diffusion 2, and this one introduced a positive and a negative prompt. So it was the first time that we were using a negative prompt. Not only that, but instead of 512 by 512, we got 768 by 768 native resolution. It was a big jump. Then we got Stable Diffusion 2.1, just improving on it. The only thing that held this model back was the fact that they remove a lot of the artist name and the style that Stable Diffusion 1.5 was trained on. Now, but then we got Stable Diffusion XL, and this one is pretty much trained on pretty much all the stars that you can imagine on. Not only that, but it can also do 1024 by 1024. So it's a big jump in resolution. Of course, it came up with a refiner. Then we got all those variation, the turbo model, the LCM, and so on. Now, after that, we got Stable Cascade. This one introduced a smaller latent space, which means that it's supposed to be faster and, of course, cheaper to train since the latent space is smaller. But people were not talking about it a lot. Instead, they were talking about this one, and this one is funny. It's Stable Diffusion 3, and I tried to load it, but as you can see, it did not load. The hype around Stable Diffusion 3 was, I think, a little bit too much. People were expecting a lot from it. When it first came out, it got released as through an API, basically, and it took a couple of months before people got their hands on the model itself. And then we got the license and all of that drama thing that happened with it. So people just switched back to SDXL. Now after that, we got Auraflow. We got 0.1, 0.2, and now we have 0.3. This is the fully open source text to image model that you can have right now. Now, of course, what everyone is talking about, now we have Flux, the Schnell version, the dev model. And if you've been following the channel, you know that we now have FP8. We also have a GGUF version that's faster. And this just shows you how long we've come in the AI image generation field. And this was just in the span of 2 years. If we go into Hugging Face, and we just check in and look at the different models that we have, there's under computer vision, you can click on text to image, and just text to image, there's 31,195 different models that you can try on. There's also the multimodal image text to image that's going to add up to this total. So I just wanted to point this out. It's been 2 years, guys, 2 years since we got Stable Diffusion, like the initial release. And I just hope that moving forward, we get more models that are easily accessible and also system requirements friendly. Because as we go forward, The models are becoming bigger and bigger, but progress keeps on going. And we know that the community just brings the model down, making it smaller and faster. So let's just say a happy birthday to Stable Diffusion. That is it for me. Thank you for watching. I will see you in the next one.